Next, we proceed to the last part, vascular tissue. So there are two types of vascular tissue, right? The most important one, xylem tissue, and also phloem tissue. So this is very important. Why? Because in semester 2, especially transport in water and transport in nutrient part, you will learn recap again. Quarterly recap again. Awak kena pun tahu, kena tahu juga itu structure dia. Kalau awak tak tahu structure dia, memang semester 2 awak tak boleh belajar lah. Okay, so you should learn. Don't think that you don't learn now. In semester 2, you don't need to learn. In semester 2, you need to repeat learn again. Okay, so vascular tissue, xylem tissue. So I think this structure, dicot one, all of you know that. Where is the location of phloem and xylem? Xylem is more, is the internal one, and phloem is the upper one for stem lah. This one is for monocot, but normally we will focus on dicot punya plant lah. So I think the location of the xylem and phloem in plant stem, plant stem and leaf, I think I don't need to repeat again. You should know already. You should master it in your SPM level. Okay, so normally in examination, it will come out the structure like this, not like this. This one is kindergarten. Ini baru SPPA punya level. So maybe in examination, it will come out the structure like this, and then it will give you, want you to label it. Maybe dia keluar sini lah, ini apa? Ini apa? Maybe like that. Especially in structure question, it will come out question like this. So please go through it. Don't think that this structure, skip it lah, akan keluar punya lah. Sorry, MPN, maybe dia akan keluar. Saya pun tak tahu. But it maybe can come out one, because in MPN syllabus, it say that you need to observe the cells under light microscope. Bukan ni. Yang ni adalah lukisan-lukisan yang cantik punya. Ni bukan microscope punya. Yang ni baru microscope. In the real situation, we look the xylem vascular tissue is like this, not xylem only. So actually it's very simple, so no, you don't need to panic how to differentiate it. So normally if you know that vascular bundle, so actually it is the enlargement for this vascular bundle, right? You know that vascular bundle. So for this part, if you know that normally the question will stay it either stem, leaf, or root, right? So if you know it is leaf, it is already the stem. So what are the xylem located at there? If you see that this is the stem already, ini stem, and then you will see that. Ya, ada satu circle yang sangat clear lah. Awak akan dapat punya sangat macam satu vascular bundle yang sangat clear punya dekat sini. So you see that, so meaning that this is the vascular bundle. And then you see here, there are epidermis right at the bottom one, epidermis. So you see the epidermis is more arranged compared to each other, right, compared to cortex. They are rectangular shape one, right? Arranged in rectangular shape, So if you know that versa is located at back, and xylem is located at back, located here, right? At the more deeper part lah. Dalam kan, phloem akan locate at the upper part, right? So yang ni dua memang phloem lah, yang ni dua memang xylem, yang ni memang xylem lah. So yang tengah-tengah ni, vascular cambium lah. Yang ni adalah vascular cambium, yang ni adalah phloem, yang ni adalah phloem fiber. So all of this you need to know lah. Ini basic structure lah, you should know one. Okay, this is just under light microscope. So normally exam, kalau dia keluar, want you to label it, it will come out the structure like this. Bukan ini, not this. Tak lah, ini SPM level. You are not SPM now, you are STPM. STPM kena tengok ni. Bukan tengok ni lah, ini kindergarten lah. Yang ni is your level. Okay, so xylem cells, we have four type of xylem cells. Xylem versa, trachea, fiber, and parenchyma. So fiber and parenchyma actually you already learned by ground tissue. But it is also one of the component that found in the xylem cells. So normally I will focus on these two lah, xylem versa and trachea. Okay, so xylem versus, so if you see here, see here, this one is xylem versus, this one is tracheid. So xylem versus normally is more thick, more gemuk sikit. You will want to compare lah, kalau gemuk sikit, yang ni kusut sikit, kurus sikit. Tapi in the examination tak boleh cakap macam ni lah, I just want to explain well lah. Yang ni gemuk sikit kan, yang ni more kurus sikit. So normally it is, both cell are the dead cell, so it is the dead, both cell also dead cell, just that xylem versus is the dead, long, hollow and continuous tube. Dia hanya satu tube je, satu tube yang panjang punya along the way, continuous tube one. Dia tak ada macam tracheid, ada satu-satu bahagian-bahagian punya. Tracheid ada satu-satu bahagian. But normally, xylem versus is just the one big tube. You can see that it is very long and big pipe lah. Dia tak ada potong-potong punya. Dia tak ada sebahagian-bahagian, bahagian sini, bahagian sana. Tak ada. Memang dia sangat panjang punya. So long, hollow and continuous tube along the way. And no, it is more wider, but shorter and thinner, but more shorter and thinner wall, less taper than tracheid. So the wall is more thinner and more shorter. And tracheid is more narrower, and more longer. And then the end of the wall of the xylem versa have holes called perforation plate to enable the water to flow freely through the xylem versa. So you see here, at the end of the xylem versa, it contains the perforation plate. And the end wall with perforation, dia ada lubang-lubang punya. You see that dia ada lubang-lubang punya. Kenapa ada lubang ni? It is to enable the water to flow freely through the xylem versa. And also, it has the lignified secondary cell wall providing the mechanical support and prevent the collapse under the tension of water transport. So normally, I already say that it is hollow tube. So it is dead cell, it does not contain any organelles one. So normally, the function is just transport water and mineral ion only. So water, if you imagine that, if water keluar sini, keluar sana, normally the cell can break right if the water is moved too fast. So we need to prevent the collapse, so it has the lignified secondary cell. So this one is to protect the cells. Okay, and then xylem versa also contain the bead, so not only xylem versa, tracheid also contain the beads. So this bead is to allow their side wall to allow the lateral transport of water between the neighboring hoop. So the water not only will pass through the tube, actually because of the beads, maybe the water can pass through this bead to another cell. So normally, xylem versa is arranged together lah, not like this one lah. Dia agak ada bayang-bayang punya kan, dia arrange to each other, and then this bead will, water maybe can pass through this bead to another type of xylem versa or go to the tracheid. So this is the function of the bead lah. Okay, another one in young plant, first xylem versa is known as protoxylem that locate bind to the apical meristem that can be stretched include annular and spiral. If growth occur, the more extensive xylem called metaxylem is formed, which cannot be stretched and rigid, include scalary form, reticulated and pitted. So this is the xylem. So if you see here this structure, so this structure is more not very clear. This one is fiber cells. Yang ni semua fiber cells. Yang ni adalah xylem versa. Versa element dotted with numerous plate. And this one is the perforation plate. So this one, these two sentences, I just want to mention that there are another two type of xylem versa called protoxylem and also metaxylem. So protoxylem is the origin of the xylem versa lah. They are baru produced from the apical meristem. Baru produce diapodial pocambium 1, and then it will produce the metaxylem. Okay. So, okay. And then after that, when it go major, it will form another vessel called as metazygote. Okay, so this is just knowledge for you. Okay, next we go to the trachea. Tadi is thalamusa, right? So tadi focus on the trachea part. So also, as same as thalam, it also the dead cell, long hauler and tube also, and it contain the thin cell with double end. Double end, meaning that it is cover one. The end of the cell is covered one. Compared to the xylem vessel is perforated end. For this one, it is double, meaning it is covered. And also more narrower compared to the xylem vessel, and it's more longer lah. And also that cell. And it has the delified secondary cell wall that prevent the entry of food substance and organelles into the hollow tube. So the function of the lignified secondary cell wall is to got two functions. One of the functions same as xylem vessel, it can provide mechanical support but another function is to prevent the entry of food substance and organelle. So that both of them are the dead cell. Why? Are the dead cell, so they cannot have any organelles. One, tak boleh ada organelle, tak boleh ada nutrient. Mereka function just transport water. Hanya transport water je. It contains the beef in the side cell wall and double end. So normally this is just to pass through our water flow is passed through from one trachea to another through beef, and then the trachea contain the beef in their side cell wall to allow lateral transport. So normally the function is same as the xylem vessel. Okay. So these are the more structure. So you see that trachea is more narrower. Okay, and then lack of secondary cell wall and peak conduction of water and nutrient and mineral ion and provide support lah. Okay, so that's all for xylem trachea. Now we go to the xylem parenchyma. So these are the location of xylem parenchyma. It is located at the site of the xylem vessel. So xylem trachea also located at the site of the xylem vessel also, but at the middle part they have xylem fiber. So these are the location for the xylem or for xylem cells. So you need to know kena tau. So kalau examination dia keluar structure like this, maybe tell you to label which is xylem vessel. So I think xylem vessel is very easy to know. Yang ni paling besar punya, paling gemuk punya, ada yang ni lubang-lubang ni, memang dia ada lah xylem vessel lah. Now, and then you go to the trachea and fiber, how to differentiate them. Trachea it contain beef lah. Awak tengok ada dia banyak lubang ke sini. Dia ada banyak lubang, so memang dia ada trachea. For xylem fiber, it is also dead cell tapi dia tak ada lubang punya. Kan, fiber tak ada lubang. Pula dia memang smooth macam ni punya, long punya tapi memang smooth punya, tak ada lubang dekat sini. So tiba memang xylem fiber. So yang xylem parenchyma is most important is it contain nucleus. Kalau ada nucleus dekat xylem punya besar, xylem cell, memang dia akan parenchyma lah, tak ada lain lah. Karena yang ni tiga memang tak ada nucleus. So these are the you need to differentiate how to if the structure come out like this. So normally no color lah, it memang black and white one. So xylem parenchyma actually normally is same as the structure and the function that you learn in ground tissue, but just that it have the specific function lah. So thin cell wall, so normally is thin cell wall, it is a living cell. And then it can form the beef phase that connect to primary xylem and secondary xylem. So you can say that it is as the connection between primary xylem and secondary xylem. And then it can form the radial sheet tissue called medullary bay, connect beef and cortex. And the major function is to help xylem vessel and trachea to transport water and gases exchange through the intercellular spaces. So you see, you know that parenchyma cell contain space, right? So this one is to help the xylem vessel and trachea to transport water through the intercellular space. So that intercellular space is to help them to transport water. Okay, so another type of xylem cell is xylem fiber. So xylem fiber is more short and narrow than tracheid. You see here, it's more short and narrow than tracheid one. So more thin to tracheid. And it also have the thicker stalwart and similar bits with the tracheid. So, and it provides strong mechanical strength and support to xylem. So normally the function is same as the tracheid.